What's happening, folks? It's your guy Rashad out here at Action Sports Bar with another Follow Me to Work, day in the life of a food truck owner. Appreciate you stopping by again, checking out a video. If you haven't already, please do give us a like, subscribe to the channel, check us out on our socials. I'd appreciate it very much, very much. This video is wedding day. We do a lot of catered business. That's a big part of the food truck business and was actually a little part of our bar and restaurant business before we even added the food trucks. But for food truck season is also wedding season lots of times. I love weddings. I love catered events. There are a couple of reasons why. One is you have minimums already set 99% of the time. So is the menu lots of times. So for ease of service and for like just peace of mind, knowing that you're gonna make the money that you wanna make, that's kind of the best things about catered business and doing weddings. When we send people quotes and we send people menus on what we can do, we explain to them that it's super, super customizable. Really just let us know what you wanna eat that day and we can pretty much make it work with enough notice. People ask us all the time, what do our plates go for? It depends on what you get, and each style and concept of food truck is going to have its own costs, its own margins, its own target value they're kind of shooting for. But for us and for me, I like the kind of sweet spot of $20 to $25 a plate is a good place to come in. We're in an expensive market, like I've said plenty of times before. The here in Seattle, it's just it's expensive, and it costs between labor and goods. So for us, $20 an hour might, or excuse me, $20 a plate might be for some places astronomical, and then for some markets they might feel like it's like $10 equivalent. So you have to do what's right for you and what's for your market, and you have to look at your numbers. Just for ballpark, for us, I like to stay in the value range of 20 to 25 bucks out the door per plate for catering. Very happy people. It was about 100 guests. We met this is actually, he used to be one of our food vendors. He went on to a different job, but always liked the food that we did and asked us if we can come out, and it was great. The other thing I love about weddings is these venues. You get a chance to go to some beautiful locations. We've been to some really, really nice locations. I always talk about us being flexible and being able to bend and being able to fit in wherever we go. This event was kind of another one of those where it was highlighted that it's nice to be like a chameleon type of food truck. We kind of, wherever we go, we try to fit the vibe we're there. This crowd was huge country fans, country music fans, a bunch of folks who, you know, are farmers and who, you know, have land, and it was a much more rural type of, environment out there, which was fun for us. We showed up and their DJ hadn't made it yet, the DJ for the wedding. So catering was there, the mobile bartenders were there, photographer was there, everybody was there, food was there, except for the DJ. So the fact that we have an audio system was huge, because we were there probably 50 minutes before the DJ got set up and got sound going. So we just cranked up our speakers and put on some, you know, country's best and Toby Keith and, you know, all the, you know, I don't really know that many artists. I just was thinking of the first one on my mind, Garth Brooks. I'm aging myself naming these country artists. But anyways, I can work Pandora and Amazon Music enough to find, you know, today's country and put it on that playlist. And so everybody was super happy. We were cranking music. The food was great. It was a beautiful environment. They got tremendous value, I believe, and everyone was very, very pleased with the food. We made, I think, good money for, you know, what we try to do. It was excellent practice again for us. We take all of these events as an opportunity for us to get better. So we did. And so we're looking forward to rolling out another wedding season and booking more of those. I think it's it's a good way to go. Food trucks for weddings are great because there's a lot of different service styles. There's a huge, tremendous amount of food variety. They're mobile, they can come and go. If you have, like, if you're doing it on a barn or out on a farm and you don't really have food, or catering wouldn't be easy for you, having a mobile kitchen drive right up, open their windows and knock your people out is great. My pro tip for catering in wedding season is this: have someone who is very organized and someone who is detail oriented as well. Be the person responsible for booking and the correspondence between the host and your business for these events. A lot of things can change and a lot of things can move. So it's nice to have someone in place who doesn't really miss small details and make sure that they leave a trail so that communications can always be taken back and make sure there's no miscommunications. Because miscommunications happen, but you want to have as much information at your fingertips when you're trying to solve problems at the end, if it comes to that. So having someone who is taking notes from the beginning, who is, you know, answering the emails and leaving a trail of communication back and forth just helps everybody execute an event that works for everyone at the end. Wow, longer than I expected, but no shock with me. Hope you all enjoy the video. We'll see you on the next one.